this really cool trophy. And it's a perpetual trophy. So on the side are engraved the names of all the previous winners, beginning with Hannah Pross in 2007 and going up to Kyra Holland in 2014. And the trophy will reside at the in the trophy case at the winning school until next year's spelling bee. This trophy was part of the strategic plan that we wanted to recognize academic excellence in the same way that we recognize athletic excellence, and I think this trophy helps to do that. Judges, are you ready? Spellers, are you ready? Okay. All right. All you have to do this time is pronounce your name into the microphone and spell your first name, okay? If you need to adjust the mic, okay, first speller.
Harry, H-A-R-R-Y.
Page, P-A-I-G-E, Page. Gracie, G-R-A-C-I-E, Gracie.
Nicole, N-I-C-O-L-E, Nicole. Grant, G-R-A-N-T, Grant.
Ally, A-L-I. Autumn, A-U-T-U-M-N.
Abigail, A-B-I-G-A-I-L.
Annabelle, A-N-N-A-B-E-L-L-E, Annabelle. Andrew, A-N-D-R-E-W.
Salvatore, S-A-L-V-A-T-O-R-E, Salvatore.
Mikey, M-I-K-E-Y, Mikey.
Quinn, Q-U-I-N, Quinn.
Emma, E-M-M-A, Emma.
David, D-A-V-I-D, David.
Alex, A-L-E-X.
Joshua, J-O-S-H-U-A.
Samantha, S-A-M-A-N-T-H-A.
Christian, C-H-R-I-S-T-I-A-N, Christian.
Garrett, G-A-R-R-E-T-T.
Claire, C-L-A-I-R-E, Claire.
Brooks, B-R-O-O-K-S.
Jessica, J-E-S-S-I-C-A.
Ashley,
Ashley, A-S-H-L-E-Y.
Ashley.
Joseph, J-O-S-E-P-H, Joseph.
Cole, C-O-L-E, Cole.
Tommy, T-H-O-M-M-I-E.
Kyra, K-Y-R-A, Kyra.
Lily, L-I-L-L-Y, Lily.
Austin, A-U-S-T-I-N, Austin.
K-Y-R-A, Kyra.
Nicholas, N-I-C-H-O-L-A-S.
Briar. B-R-Y-A-R.
Briar.
Wait. Briar.
Carson. C-A-R-S-O-N. Carson.
Maya. M-A-I-A. Maya. Sage, S-A-G-E, Sage. Eric, E-R-I-K, Eric.
Dominic, D-O-M-E-N-I-C, Dominic.
Nestor, N-E-S-T-O-R.
John, J-O-H-N, John.
Nathaniel, N-A-T-H-A-N-I-E-L, Nathaniel.
Jude, J-U-D-E, Jude.
And those are our spellers. Do we have someone just come in? Let me just remind you, spellers, that it's good practice to pronounce the word after I pronounce it. That way we can be sure you've understood the word that I've pronounced. It's not required, but if you begin spelling a word and then it turns out you didn't understand which word I said, you're going to miss the word. We don't want you to misunderstand what I'm saying. Also, it's not necessary to indicate that a word has a capital letter. You just need to say the letters. It's not necessary to say that there's a space if you get a two-word word. And it's not necessary to indicate accents or anything like that. You just have to say the letters correctly in the correct order. If you want to start over, you may start over, but you may not change anything you already said. Okay? Everybody got it? Okay. I saw a hand in the back. Did I answer your question? What is your question? No, you don't have to say the hyphens or any. If you would get a hyphenated word, it's not necessary to say the hyphen. You may say it if you choose to, but it's not required. Yes. When in subsequent rounds, Mr. Lucas will rearrange you and pull you front at that point, yes. But don't move the order until he does that. Yes, ma'am.
If you say a word and you say it with a hyphen, but the word doesn't have a hyphen in it, is that wrong?
We don't think so, but the decision of the judges is always final. I'm not the decider here. I'm just the pronouncer. Any other questions? Yes, Kyra.
I have a kind of comment. How about just no hyphens? Like, if you think there's a hyphen, don't have a hyphen. I mean, because hyphens are required.
Yeah, it's probably better not to say any punctuation because it's not required. Good point. Okay? We all relax and ready? Okay. All righty. Okay? You're first. It would be helpful if you try to face the judges when you spell as well so that they can see your lips. That sometimes helps them understand, say, the difference between M and N, just watching how you spell. Okay? Harry, your word is easel. Easel.
Easel. E-A-S-E-L. Easel.
That is correct. Your word is goatee. Goatee.
Goatee. G-O-A-T-E-E. Goatee?
Correct. Your word is average. Average.
Average. A-V-E-R-A-G-E. Average.
Correct. Whirlpool. Whirlpool.
Whirlpool. W-H-I-R-L-P-O-O-L. Whirlpool.
Correct. Ninja.
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 N-I-N-J-A. Ninja.
Reckless, reckless.
Reckless. R-E-C-K-L-E-S-S. Reckless.
Correct. Your word is mongoose. Mongoose.
Mongoose. M-O-N-G-O-O-S-E. Mongoose.
Your word has a near homonym, so I'm going to give you the definition so that you clearly understand the word. The word is errand. Errand. It means a trip made in order to deliver a message or to purchase or attend to something. Errand.
Errand. E-R-R-A-N-D. Errand.
Correct. Your word is deluxe. Deluxe.
Deluxe. D-E-L-U-X-E. Deluxe.
Correct. Your word also is a near homonym, so I'm going to give you the definition before you begin to spell. Okay? The word is cashew. Cashew. It's a kidney-shaped nut of tropical American tree, naturalized in all warm countries. Cashew.
Cashew. C-A-S-H-E-W. Cashew?
Correct. Your word is also a near homonym, so let me give you the definition. The word is polka, and it is a vivacious couple dance of Bohemian origin with three steps and a hop in duple time. Polka.
Polka. P-O-C-K-A. Polka.
I'm sorry, the correct spelling is P-O-L-K-A. Polka. Your word is walrus. Walrus.
Walrus. W-A-L-R-U-S. Walrus.
Correct. Your word is mohair. Mohair.
Can I have the definition?
Yes, you may. Mohair is any of various fabrics or yarns made wholly or in part of hair of the Angora goat. Mohair.
Can you use it in a sentence, please?
Certainly. For her birthday, Linda got a matching scarf and sweater made of mohair.
Mohair. M-O-H-A-I-R. Mohair.
Correct. Your word is anvil. Anvil.
Can I have that in a sentence, please?
You may. The blacksmith flattened and shaped the horseshoe on his anvil.
A N F. May I please start over?
You may.
A N V U L L. Anvil.
I'm sorry. When you start over, you can't change a letter. That's for everybody. Remember, when you start over, you may not change a letter that's already said. Your word is canary. Canary.
Canary. K-A-N-A-R-Y. Canary.
I'm sorry, the correct spelling is C-A-N-A-R-Y. Your word is magazine. Magazine.
Magazine. M-A-G-A-Z-I-N-E. Magazine.
That is correct. Your word is hustle. Hustle.
Hustle. H-U-S-T-L-E. Hustle.
Correct. Your word is barley. Barley.
Barley. B-A-R-L-E-Y. Barley.
Correct. Your word is orchard. Orchard.
Orchard. O R C H A R D. Orchard.
Correct. Your word has a homonym, so I'm going to give you the definition. The word is alderman. Alderman. It's a member of a legislative body of a city. Alderman.
Could you use it in a sentence, please?
I can. The mayoral candidate received the endorsement of the city's longest-serving alderman.
Alderman. A-L-D-E-R-M-A-N. Alderman.
Correct. Your word is hundredth. Hundredth.
Hundredth. H-U-N-D-E-R-T-H.
I'm sorry, the correct spelling is H-U-N-D-R-E-D-T-H, hundredth. Your word could be confused with a similar word, so I'm going to give you the definition. The word is ravel, ravel. It means to become untwisted, unwoven, unwound, or to fray. Ravel.
Ravel. R-A-V-E-L. Ravel.
Correct. Your word is buffalo. Buffalo.
Buffalo. B-U-F-F-A-L-O. Buffalo.
Correct. Your word is mermaid. Mermaid.
Mermaid. M-E-R-M-A-I-D. Mermaid.
Correct. Lower? You good?
Yeah.
Okay. Your word is electoral.
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 E-L-E-C-T-O-R-A-L. Electoral.
Correct. Your word is beige. Beige.
Can you use it in a sentence, please?
I can. Tired of the beige walls in her home, Ellen decided to repaint all the rooms with bold colors. Beige.
Beige. B-A-I-G-E.
Correct spelling is B-E. I-G-E, beige. Your word is totem. Totem.
Totem. T-O-T-O-M. Totem.
No, I'm sorry. The correct spelling is T-O-T-E-M. Totem. Your word is cummerbund. Cummerbund.
Cummerbund. C-U-M-M-E-R-B-U-N-D. Cummerbund.
That is correct. Your word is necessary. Necessary.
Necessary. N-E-C-E-S-S-A-R-Y. Necessary.
Correct. Your word could be confused with a similar word, so I will give you a definition before you begin to spell. The word is slaughter. Slaughter. And it means the mass killing and bloodshed as in a war. Slaughter.
Slaughter. S-L-A-U-G-H-T-E-R. Slaughter.
Correct. Your word is hibachi. Hibachi.
May I have the language of origin, please?
This word is from the Japanese, hibachi.
Hibachi. H-I-B-A-C-H-I.
That's correct. Your word is pragmatic. Pragmatic.
Pragmatic. P-R-A-G-M-A-T-I-C. Pragmatic.
That is correct. Your word is discipline. Discipline.
Discipline. D-I-C-S-I-P-L-I-N-E. Discipline.
I'm sorry, the correct spelling is D-I-S-C-I-P-L-I-N-E. Your word is saxophone. Saxophone.
Saxophone. X A C K S A P H O N E. Saxophone.
I'm sorry, the correct spelling is S A X. O-P-H-O-N-E, saxophone. Your word is fiesta. Fiesta.
Fiesta. F-I-E-S-T-A, fiesta.
Correct. Your word is mahi-mahi. Mahi-mahi.
Mahi-mahi. M-A-H-I-M-A-H-I.
That's correct. Your word is periscope. Periscope.
Periscope. P-A-R-A-S-C-O-P-E. Periscope.
I'm sorry, the correct spelling is P-E-R-I-S-C-O-P-E. Your word is admiral.
Admiral. A-D-M-I-R-A-L, admiral.
That is correct. Your word is manicure. Manicure.
Manicure. M-A-N-A-C-U-R-E. Manicure.
I'm sorry, the correct spelling is M-A-I-C-U-R-E. Manicure. Your word is rucksack. Rucksack.
Can I have the definition?
Yes, a rucksack is a bag or case, often of canvas, supported on the back by a string over each shoulder, or by a strap over each shoulder. Rucksack, rucksack.
Rucksack. R-U-C-K-S-A-C-K. Rucksack.
Correct. Your word is bambino. Bambino.
Bambino. B-A-M-B-I-N-O. Bambino.
That is correct. And your word is fidelity. Fidelity.
Could I have the definition, please?
Certainly. Fidelity is the quality or state of being faithful or loyal as to a person, cause, party, or nation. Fidelity.
Could I have it in a sentence, please?
Certainly. When taking the oath of office, the President of the United States pledges fidelity to the Constitution.
F E D E L I T Y, fidelity.
Sorry, the correct spelling is F I D E L I T Y. That is the end of the first round. If you missed a word, you may leave the stage. Everyone else, stay in your seat. Okay, your first word is cockatoo. Cockatoo.
Cockatoo. C-O-C-K-A-T-O-O. Cockatoo.
That is correct. Your word is behoove.
Behoove.
Behoove. Say it one more time so I'm sure you got it.
Behoove?
Behoove, yes.
Can I have its origin?
The origin is originally English. Behoove.
Behoove. B-E-H-O-O-V-E.
That is correct. Your word is homonym. Homonym.
Homonym. H-O-M-O-N-Y-M. Homonym.
That is correct. Your word is ventilate. Ventilate.
Ventilate. V-E-N-T-I-L-A-T-E. Ventilate.
Correct. Your word is typhoon. Typhoon.
Typhoon. T-Y-P-H-O-O-N. Typhoon.
Correct. Your word is finale. Finale.
Finale. May I have a definition, please?
Yes. The finale is the last section or movement of an instrumental musical composition. Finale.
Finale. Finale. F-I-N-A-L-E. Finale.
That is correct. Your word is begonia. Begonia.
Begonia. B-E-G-O-N-I-A. Begonia.
Correct. Your word is dungaree. Dungaree.
Can I have the language of origin, please?
The word is from Hindi.
Okay.
Dungaree.
Can you use it in a sentence?
Certainly. Trousers made of dungaree are very practical for outdoor work. Dungaree.
Dungaree. D-U-N-G-A-R-E-E.
That's correct. Your word is prosecute. Prosecute.
Could you please say that in a sentence?
Certainly. Some cities do not prosecute jaywalkers because of the high court costs involved. Prosecute.
Prosecute. P-R-O-S-E-C-U-T-E. Prosecute.
That's correct. Your word has a near homonym, so I'm going to give you the definition first. The word is jackal. Jackal. Jackal is any of several small wild dogs of the old world, less daring than wolves, sometimes hunting in packs, but more usually singly or in pairs, and feeding on carrion and small animals. Jackal.
Jackal. J-A-C-K-E-L. Jackal.
I'm sorry, it's J-A-C-K-A-L, jackal. Your word is cabana.
May I have the origin, please?
It's a word that went from Latin into Spanish, cabana.
Cabana. C-A-B-A-N-A, cabana.
That is correct. Your word is knavery. Knavery.
Can I have the definition, please?
Yes. Knavery means the practices of a petty villain, fraud, or trickery. Knavery.
Can you use it in a sentence, please?
Kathleen's essay explored the knavery of the character Fagin in the novel Oliver Twist. Knavery.
Knavery. N-A-V-E-R-Y. Knavery.
Has a silent K. K-N-A-V-E-R-Y. Sorry. Your word is transect. Transect.
Transect. T-R-A-N-S-E-C-T. Transect.
That is correct. Your word is biopsy. Biopsy.
Biopsy. B-I-O-P-S-Y. Biopsy.
Correct. Your word is albatross. Albatross.
Can I have a definition, please?
You may. Albatross is any of a number of large web-footed seabirds that are related to the petrels, and that include the largest of the seabirds, being capable of long continued flight and appearing often at great distances from land, chiefly over southern seas. Albatross.
Albatross. A L B A T R O S S. Albatross.
That is correct. Your word is parfait. Parfait.
May you use that in a sentence, please?
I will do that for you. Following a light lunch, Carmen ordered a parfait of tropical fruits. Parfait.
Can you use that in a definition, please?
Yes. Parfait is a cold dessert consisting of alternating layers of fruit, syrup, ice cream, and whipped cream, served in a tall, narrow glass with a short stem.
Parfait.
Parfait.
P-A-R-F-E-T, parfait.
I'm sorry, the correct spelling is P-A-R-F-A-I-T, parfait. Your word has a near homonym.
Again.
And I'm going to give you the definition. The word is cobalt. Cobalt is a hard, magnetic, silver-white metallic element used to produce magnetic alloys and hard alloys resistant to abrasion, corrosion, and high temperatures. Cobalt.
Cobalt. C-O-B-A-L-T. Cobalt.
That is correct. Your word is gondola. Gondola.
Gondola. G-O-N-D-O-L-A. Gondola.
That is correct. Your word is contiguous. Contiguous.
Can you use that in a sentence, please?
Yes. Mr. Wallace understands but resents higher shipping fees charged to U.S. customers living in states outside the contiguous 48.
Can I have the definition, please?
Contiguous means touching or connected throughout. Contiguous.
C-O-N-T. U-S... S?
I'm sorry, the correct spelling is C-O-N-T-I-G-U-O-U-S, contiguous. Your word is Flemish. Flemish.
Flemish. F L E M. I S H. Flemish.
That is correct. Your word is cafeteria. Cafeteria.
Cafeteria. C-A-F-E-T-E-R-I-A. Cafeteria.
That is correct. Your word is persimmon. Persimmon.
Persimmon. P-E-R-S-I-M-M-O-N. Persimmon.
Your word is liverwurst. Liverwurst.
Liverwurst. L-I-V-E-R-W-O-R-S-T. Liverwurst.
I'm sorry, the correct spelling is L-I-V-E-R-W-U-R-S-T. Your word is confetti. Confetti.
Using a sentence?
Certainly. Ticker tape and confetti swirled like snow over the celebration parade.
Confetti. C-O-N-F-E-T-T-I. Confetti.
Correct. Your word is semantics. Semantics.
Semantics. S-E-M-A-N-T-I-C-S. Semantics.
That is correct. I don't want you to bend over. Can you get higher? You're okay. There you go. Is your word is haiku. Haiku.
Haiku. H-A-I-K-U, haiku.
That is correct. Your word could be confused with another word, so I'm going to give you the definition, okay? The word is mutable, mutable. And mutable means open to debate, or debatable. Mutable.
May I have it in a sentence, please?
Yes. The mutable issue was debated by lawyers and finally decided by a judge. Mutable.
Mutable. M-U-T-I-B-L-E. Mutable.
I'm sorry, the correct spelling is M-O-O-T-A-B-L-E. Your word is expertise. Expertise.
Expertise. E-X-P-E-R-T-I-S-E. Expertise.
Correct. Your word is clementine. Clementine.
Clementine. C-L-E-M-E-N-T-I-N-E. Clementine.
Correct. Your word is jaguar.
Jaguar. J-A-G-U-A-R. Jaguar.
Correct. Your word is agnostic. Agnostic.
Agnostic. A-G-N-O-S-T-I-C. Agnostic.
That is correct. And that is the end of round two. Your word is inferno. Inferno.
Can I have the language of origin, please?
This word comes from Italian, which formed it from a Latin word, inferno.
Inferno. I-N-F-E-R-N-O.
Correct. Your word is Sputnik.
Sputnik. Word of origin?
Russian.
Sputnik. S-P-U-T-N-I-K, Sputnik.
That is correct. Your word is macron. Macron.
Definition, please.
A macron is a mark placed over a vowel to indicate that the vowel is long. It's placed over a syllable or used alone to indicate stressed or long syllable in a foot of verse. Macron.
Origin of the word, please.
It is from the Greek.
Okay. Macron. M-A-C-R-O-N. Macron.
That is correct. Your word is herbivore. Herbivore.
Herbivore. H-E-R-B-I-V-O-R. Herbivore.
I'm sorry, it is H-E-R-B-I-V-O-R-E.
Oh.
Your word is physique. Physique.
Physique. P-H-Y-S-I-Q-U-E. Physique.
That is correct. Your word could be confused with a different word, so I'm going to give you the definition first. The word is langosta. Langosta. It is a South or Central American spiny lobster. Langosta.
May I have it in a sentence, please?
Beth ordered morsels of langosta and sea scallops on a skewer for an appetizer.
Langosta.
Langosta.
L-A-N-G. U-S-T-A, langosta?
I'm sorry, the correct spelling is L-A-N-G-O-S-T-A, langosta. Your word is topography. Topography.
Topography. T-O-P-O-G-R-A-P-H-Y, topography.
That is correct. Your word is Frankenstein.
Frankenstein. F-R-A-N-K-E-N-S-T-E-I-N.
That is correct. Your word is rough-hewn. Rough-hewn.
Could you please give me the origin?
It consists of two originally English elements, rough-hewn.
Could you say it in a sample sentence?
Yes. The new post office clerk has a certain rough-hewn charm, rough-hewn.
R-O-U-G-H-U-G-N, rough-hewn.
I'm sorry, the correct spelling is R-O-U-G-H-H-E-W-N, rough-hewn. Your word is benefactor. Benefactor.
May I have the origin, please?
The first part of this word is from an originally Latin word, and the second part is an English combining form, benefactor.
Benefactor. B-E-N-E-F-A-C-T-O-R. Benefactor.
Correct. Your word has a homonym, so I'm going to give you the definition. The word is palate. Palette. It means a particular range, quality, or use of color. Palette.
Palette. P-A-L-E-T-T-E. Palette.
Correct. Your word is wiseacre. Wiseacre.
Can I have the definition?
Certainly. Wiseacre is one who represents himself as well-informed or clever. A smart aleck. Wiseacre.
Wiseacre. W-I-S-E-A-C-R-E. Wiseacre.
Correct. Your word is henna. Henna.
Can I have a definition, please?
Yes. Henna is a reddish-brown dye obtained from the leaves of the henna plant. Henna.
Henna. H-E-N-A. Henna.
I'm sorry, the correct spelling is H-E-N-N-A. Double N. Word is simile. Simile.
Simile. S-I-M-I-L-Y. Simile.
Sorry. S-I-M-I-L-E. Simile. Your word is obstinate. Obstinate.
Obstinate. O-B-S-T. Can you repeat the word?
Obstinate.
O-B-S-T-I-N-I-T-E. Obstinate.
I'm sorry. O-B-S-T-I-N-A-T-E. Obstinate. Your word is shogun. Shogun.
Can you give me the definition, please?
Yes. A shogun is a military governor of Japan before the mid-19th century revolution with power exceeding an emperor's. Shogun.
Shogun. S-H-O-G-U-N. Shogun.
That is correct. Your word is portfolio. Portfolio.
Portfolio. P-O-R-T-F-O-L-I-O. Portfolio.
That is correct. Your word is dynamic. Dynamic.
Dynamic. D Y N A M I C, dynamic.
Correct. Your word is kahuna.
Can you use it in a sentence?
Yes. A kahuna is regarded as a guardian of healing secrets. Kahuna.
Kahuna. C A H O O N A, kahuna.
I'm sorry, the correct spelling is K-A-H-U-N-A, kahuna. Your word is filament.
Filament.
F-I-L-A-M-E-N-T, filament.
That is correct. Your word is artichoke. Artichoke.
Artichoke. A-R-T-I-C-H-O-K-E, artichoke.
Correct. Your word is democracy.
Democracy. D-E-M-O-C-R-A-C-Y, democracy.
That is correct. Your word is Gestapo. Gestapo.
Gestapo. Can I have language of origin, please?
The word is from a German acronym, Gestapo.
Gestapo. G-E-S-T-A-P-O, Gestapo.
Correct. Your word is post-mortem. Post-mortem.
Can I have the definition?
Certainly. Post-mortem means an examination of a body after death to determine the cause of death or the character and extent of changes produced by disease. Post-mortem.
Can you use it in a sentence?
The post-mortem revealed that the cause of death was asphyxiation. Post-mortem.
Post-mortem. P O S T M O R T E M, postmortem.
That is correct. Your word is tomatillo.
Tomatillo. T O M A-T-I-O, tomatillo.
I'm sorry, the correct spelling is T-O-M-A-T-I-L-L-O, tomatillo. And that is the end of round three. Might want to move them up. Oh, Mr. Lucas needs a second. It's okay. Your word is souvenir. Souvenir.
Souvenir. S-O-U-V-E-N-I-R.
That is correct. Your word is hydrology. Hydrology.
Hydrology. H-Y. D-R-O-L-O-G-Y.
That is correct. Your word is mahal. Mahal.
May I have the origin, please?
This word is from an Arabic word. Mahal.
Mahal. M-A-H-A-L. Mahal.
That is correct. Your word has a near homonym, so I'm going to give you the definition. The word is pronounced kitsch. Kitsch. Kitsch is artistic or literary material held to be of low quality, often produced to appeal to a popular taste, and marked especially by sentimentalism, sensationalism, and slickness. Kitsch.
Kitsch. K-I-T-C-H, kitsch.
I'm sorry, the correct spelling is K-I-T-S-C-H, kitsch. Your word is origami. Origami.
Origami. O-R-I-G-A-M-I, origami.
That is correct. Your word is consensus. Consensus.
Can I have the origin, please?
The word comes to us from Latin. Consensus.
Consensus. C-O-N-S-E-N-S-U-S.
That is correct. Your word is matic. Matic.
Matic. Origin, please.
The word is a word that went from Latin to English.
Matic.
Matic.
M-A-T-T-O-C-K, matic.
That is correct. Your word is succotash. Succotash.
Succotash. S-U-C-K-A-T-A-S-H.
I'm sorry, the correct spelling is S-U-C-C-O-T-A-S-H, succotash. Your word is lethargy. Lethargy.
Lethargy. L-E-T-H-A-R-G-Y. Lethargy.
Correct. Your word is nirvana. Nirvana.
Can you use that in a sentence, please?
Yes. Fiona's idea of nirvana is a weekend at her lakeside cabin. Nirvana.
Nirvana. N-I-R-V-A-N-A. Nirvana.
Correct. Your word is Kremlin. Kremlin.
Kremlin. C-R-A-M-B-L-I-N-E.
I'm sorry, the correct spelling is K-R-E-M-L-I-N, Kremlin. Your word is desperado. Desperado.
Desperado. D-E-S-P-E-R-A-D-O. Desperado.
Correct. Kyra. Your word is ominous. Ominous.
May I have it in a sentence, please?
Yes. For an instant, there was an ominous stillness, quieter and more silent than ever before, as if even the air was holding a breath. Ominous.
Ominous. O-M-I-N-O-U-S. Ominous.
That is correct. Your word is influenza. Influenza.
Influenza. I-N-F-L-U-E-N-Z-A. Influenza.
Correct. Okay. Your word is Cryptic. Cryptic.
Cryptic. C-R-Y-P-T-I-C. Cryptic.
Correct. Your word is a homonym, so I'm going to give you the definition. The word is guilder. Guilder. The definition is any of various silver coins, especially a Dutch gulden. Guilder.
Guilder. G-I-L-D-E-R. Guilder.
I'm sorry, the correct spelling is G-U-I-L-D-E-R. Guilder. Your word is paradox. Paradox.
Can I have the definition?
You may. A paradox is a statement or sentiment that is seemingly contradictory or opposed to common sense and yet perhaps true in fact. Paradox. Paradox.
Paradox. P-A-R-A-D-O-C-S. Paradox.
Sorry, the correct spelling is P-A-R-A-D-O-X. That is the end of round four. Begin round five. Your word is angst. Angst.
Ooh. Angst, A-N-G-S-T.
Okay. I wasn't sure if you heard me. Okay, angst. Idiom. Your word is idiom.
Idiom. I-D-I-O-M. Idiom.
Correct. Your word is macadamia. Macadamia.
Origin, please.
This word is from an Australian name that went into Latin. Macadamia.
Macadamia. M-A-C-A-D-A-M-I-A.
Correct. Your word is alliteration. Alliteration.
Alliteration. A-L-L-I-T-E-R-I-T-O-I-O-N. Alliteration.
I'm sorry, the correct spelling is A-L-L-I-T-E-R-A-T-I-O-N. Your word has a homonym, so I will give you the definition. The word is foliate. Foliate. And it means shaped like a leaf. Foliate.
Can you give me the origin, please?
The word is from Latin. Foliate.
Foliate. F-O. L-I-A-T-E, foliate.
That is correct. Your word is parmesan. Parmesan.
Origin, please.
The word is from an Italian geographical name. Okay. Parmesan.
Parmesan. P-A-R-M-A-S-A-N, parmesan.
I'm sorry, it's P-A-R-M-E-S-A-N. Your word is colloquial. Colloquial.
Colloquial. C-O-L-L-O-Q-U-I-A-L. Colloquial.
That is correct. Your word is hacienda. Hacienda.
Can you use it in a sentence, please?
Certainly. A winding tree-lined driveway led to the hacienda.
Hacienda. H O S I E N D A, hacienda.
I'm sorry, the correct spelling is H A C I E N D A. Your word is bolero. Bolero.
Bolero. B O L E R O. Bolero.
That is correct. Your word is paprika. Paprika.
May I have the language of origin, please?
This word is from a word that went from Greek to Serbian to Hungarian, paprika.
Paprika. P-A-P-R-I-K-A, paprika.
That is correct. Your word is barrage. Barrage.
Barrage. B-A-R-R-A-G-E. Barrage.
Correct. Your word is implement. Implement.
Implement. I-M-P-L-E-M-E-N-T. Implement.
That is correct. And that is the end of the round. Your word is analysis. Analysis.
Analysis. A-N-A-L-Y-S-I-S.
Correct. Your word is prosaic. Prosaic.
Word of origin, please.
The word comes to us from Latin, prosaic.
Can I have the definition?
Yes. Prosaic, it means belonging to or characteristic of language intended primarily to give information, relate events, or communicate ideas or opinions as distinguished from the language of poetry. Prosaic.
Prosaic. Prosaic. P-R-O-S-A-I-C?
Correct. Your word is enthusiasm. Enthusiasm.
Enthusiasm. E-N-T-H-U-S- I A S U M, enthusiasm.
I'm sorry, the correct spelling is E N T H U S I A S M. Your word is megalopolis. Megalopolis.
Can you give me the origin, please?
The word comes to us from the Greek, megalopolis.
Megalopolis. M-E-G. Can you say it again?
Megalopolis.
Can I start over?
You may.
Megalopolis. M-E-G-O-L-O-P-O-L-I-S.
I'm sorry, the correct spelling is M-E-G-A-L-O-P-O-L-I-S. Your word is sayonara.
Can I have the definition, please?
Sayonara is a concluding remark at parting.
Language of origin?
Japanese.
Sayonara. S-Y-A-N-O-R-A. Sayonara.
I'm sorry, the correct spelling is S-A-Y-O-N-A-R-A. Your word is cruller.
Cruller. C-R-U-L-L-E-R. Cruller.
Correct. Your word is mercurial. Mercurial.
May I have the language of origin, please?
The word is from the Latin. Mercurial.
May I please have it in a sentence?
Yes. Christopher's mercurial twists of temperament were a trial for his mother. Mercurial.
Mercurial. M E R C U R I A L. Mercurial.
That is correct. Your word is doctrinaire. Doctrinaire.
Doctrinaire. D-O-C-T-R-I-N-A-I-R-E. Doctrinaire.
That is correct. Your word is maestro.
Maestro. M-A-E-S-T-R-O. Maestro.
That is correct. And that's the end of the round. Your word is synergy. Synergy.
Can I have the word of origin?
This word is from originally a Greek word that passed into Latin. Synergy.
Definition?
Synergy means combined action or operation as of muscles or nerves. Synergy.
Synergy. S-I-N-N-E-R-G-Y.
The correct spelling is S-Y-N-E-R-G-Y. Your word is ampere.
Ampere? Mm-hmm. A-M-P-E-R-E, ampere.
Correct. Your word is providence. Providence.
Providence, P-R-O-V-I-D-E-N-C-E, Providence.
Correct. Your word is Malihini. Malihini.
Malihini, M-A-L-I-H-I-N-I, Malihini.
That is correct. Your word is credenza. Credenza.
Credenza. C-R-E-D-E-N-Z-A.
Credenza.
Credenza. Okay, that's the end of that round. Alrighty. Your word is Samaritan. Samaritan.
Samaritan. S-A-M-A-R-I-T-A-N.
Correct. Your word is protagonist. Protagonist.
Protagonist. P-R-O-T-A-G-O-N-I-S-T. Protagonist.
Correct. Your word is Amarillo. Amarillo.
Amarillo. A M A R I L L O. Amarillo.
Correct. Your word is meticulous. Meticulous.
Meticulous. M-E-T-I-C-U-L-O-U-S. Meticulous.
Correct. Your word is subterfuge. Subterfuge.
Subterfuge. S-U-B-T-E-R-F-U-G-E. Subterfuge.
Correct. Your word is intractable. Intractable.
Language of origin, please.
This word comes to us from Latin. Okay. Intractable.
Intractable. I-N-T-R-A-C-T-A-B-L-E.
Correct. Your word is piccolo.
Piccolo. Piccolo. P-I-C-C-O-L-O. Piccolo.
Okay. Apostrophe.
Apostrophe. A-P-O-S-T-R-O-P-H-E. Apostrophe.
Your word is pacifism. Pacifism.
Pacifism. P-A-C-I-F-I-S-M. Pacifism.
Correct. Your word is saffron.
Saffron. S-A-F-F-R-O-N. Saffron.
Another good round. Your word is erudite. Erudite.
Erudite. Erudite. A-R-E-A-D-I-T-E.
Sorry, the correct spelling is E-R-U-D-I-T-E. Your word is mistletoe.
Mistletoe. M-I-S-T-L-E-T-O-E, mistletoe.
Correct. Your word is pasteurize. Pasteurize.
Pasteurize. P-A-S-T-E-U-R-I-Z-E. Pasteurize.
That is correct. Your word could be confused with another word, so I'm going to give you the definition. The word is barabara. Barabara means a sod or turf hut of northern Siberia or of Alaska, especially a hut of the Aleutian Islanders built partly or wholly underground. Bara bara.
Bara bara. B-A-R-A-B-A-R-A. Bara bara.
Correct. Your word is spinet.
Spinet. S-P-I-N-N-E-T, spinet.
I'm sorry, it's one N. S-P-I-N-E-T. Okay, it's the end of that round. Good job. Okay. Your word is chagrin.
Chagrin. C-H-A-G-R-I-N. Chagrin.
Correct. Your word is endemic. Endemic.
May I have the language of origin?
This word comes to us from the Greek, endemic.
May I have it used in a sentence, please?
Certainly. Despite its name, Rocky Mountain spotted fever is not endemic to the western United States. Endemic.
May I have a definition, please?
Endemic means peculiar to a locality or region, used of a disease that is constantly present to a greater or lesser extent in a particular place. Endemic.
May I please repeat the word?
Endemic.
Endemic. E N D E M-I-C.
Correct. Your word has a near homonym, so I'm going to give you the definition before you begin to spell. The word is protocol. Protocol means a rigid, long-established code prescribing complete deference to a superior rank and strict adherence to due order of precedence and precisely correct procedure. Protocol.
Protocol. P-R-O-T-O-C-O-L, protocol.
Correct. Okay. The end of a round. Now, clap. I've lost track. What number round is this? 12? Round 12. Okay. Your word is ubiquitous. Ubiquitous.
Ubiquitous. U-B-I-Q-U-I-T-O-U-S. Ubiquitous.
Correct. Your word has a near homonym, so I'm going to give you the definition. The word is tariff, and tariff means a duty or rate of duty imposed by a government on imported or exported goods for the production of revenue, for the artificial fostering of home industries, or as a means of coercing foreign governments to grant reciprocity privileges. Tariff.
Tariff. T-A-R-I-F-F. Tariff.
Correct. Your word is quinine.
Quinine. Q-U-I-N-I-N-E, quinine.
Correct. Applause. Round 13. Your word is capitulation. Capitulation.
Capitulation. C-A-P-I-T-U-L-A-T-I-O-N, capitulation.
Correct. Your word is Schloss.
Schloss. S-C-H-L-O-S-S. Schloss.
Correct. Impetuous.
Impetuous. I-M-P-E-T-U-O-U-S. Impetuous.
Correct. Your word is cravat.
Cravat. C-R-A-V-A-T. Cravat.
Correct. Your word is melancholy. Melancholy.
Melancholy. M-E-L-A-N-C-H-O-L-Y. Melancholy.
Correct. Your word is gourami, gourami.
Language of origin, please.
The word is from Malay. Gourami.
Could you use that in a sentence?
Jonathan bought a colorful gourami for his new aquarium. Gourami.
G-O-R-A-M-I, gourami.
Sorry, it's G-O-U-R-A-M-I. Okay, applause. I predict that the winner of this bee will be named Kyra. Your word is oregano.
Oregano. O-R-E-G-A-N-O. Oregano.
Hedonism.
Hedonism. H-E-D-O-N-I-S-M. Hedonism.
Correct. Yep. Samurai.
Samurai. S-A-M-U-R-A-I. Samurai.
Dressage.
Dressage. D-R-E-S-S-A-G-E. Dressage.
Correct. Your word is palmetto.
Palmetto. Palmetto. P-A-L-M-E-T-T-O.
Isinglass.
Isinglass. I-S-I-N-G-L-A-S-S. Isinglass.
Your word is maelstrom.
Maelstrom. Maelstrom. M-A-E-L-S-T-R-O-M. Maelstrom.
Correct. Bellicose.
Bellicose. B-E-L-L-I-C-O-S-E. Bellicose.
Langlauf.
Langlauf. L-A-N-G-L-A-U-F. Langlauf.
Correct. Rhetoric.
Rhetoric. R-H-E-T-O-R-I-C. Rhetoric.
Yeah. Azimuth. Azimuth.
Azimuth. A-Z-I-M-U-T-H. Azimuth.
Correct. Contrapuntal. Contrapuntal.
Contrapuntal. C-O-N-T-R-A-P-U-N-T-A-L. Contrapuntal.
Mikado.
Mikado. M-I-K-A-D-O. Mikado.
Correct. Prerogative. Prerogative.
May I have the language of origin, please?
It comes to us from Latin. Prerogative.
May I have it in a sentence?
Mom says that it's a female's prerogative to change her mind.
Prerogative. P-R-E-R-O-G-A-T-I-V-E.
Correct. Wow. Forsythia.
Forsythia. F-O-R-S-Y-T-H-I-A, Forsythia.
Correct. Okay. Détente.
Détente. D-E-T-E-N-T-E. Détente.
Correct. Hypocrisy.
Hypocrisy. H-Y-P-O-C-R-I-S-Y. Hypocrisy.
Correct. Egregious. Egregious.
Egregious. E-G-R-E-G-I-O-U-S. Egregious.
Correct. Wow. Basmati. Basmati.
Basmati. B-A-S-M-A-T-I. Basmati.
Archipelago.
Archipelago. A-R-C-H-I-P-E-L-A-G-O. Archipelago.
Correct. Ocelot.
Ocelot. O-C-E-L-O-T. Ocelot.
Soliloquy.
Soliloquy. S-O-L-I-L-O-Q-U-Y. Soliloquy.
Correct. Asthmogenic. Asthmogenic.
Asthmogenic. A-S-T-H-M-O-G-E-N-I-C. Asthmogenic.
Correct. This word has a near homonym. So I'm going to give you the definition before you start. It's pronounced duan. It is a building where customs and duties are paid or collected, or where vessels are entered and cleared. Duan.
May I have the language of origin, please?
This word is from an originally Persian word that passed into Arabic, and then into Italian, and then into French. Duan.
Duan. D-O-U-A-N-E. Duan.
That is correct. Infinitesimal. Infinitesimal.
I-N-F-I-N-I-T-E-S-I-M-A-L. Infinitesimal.
Okay. This word also has a near homonym, so I'm going to give you the definition. The word is philately. Philately. It means the collection and study of postage stamps and of postal stationery that has passed through the mail. In other words, stamp collecting. Philately.
P-H-I-L-A-T-E-L-Y. Philately.
That is correct. Okay. Your word is chintzy.
Chintzy. C-H-I-N-T-Z-Y.
Correct. Chintzy. Your word is surfeit.
Surfeit. S-U-R-F-E-I-T. Surfeit.
Correct. Epay.
Epay. E-P-E-E. Epay.
Correct. Domiciled.
Domiciled. D-O-M-I-C-I-L-E-D, domiciled.
Correct. Okay. Your word is zeitgeist, zeitgeist.
Zeitgeist, Z-E-I-T-G-E-I-S-T, zeitgeist.
Your word is pusillanimous.
Pusillanimous. P-U-S-I-L-L-A-N-I-M-O-U-S. Pusillanimous.
Correct.
What round is this?
I have no idea. 38? Okay. Your word has two correct spellings, so either one will be acceptable. Reconnoiter.
Reconnoiter. R-E-C-O-N-N-O-I-T-R-E. Reconnoiter.
Correct. Your word is adumbrate, adumbrate.
Adumbrate, A-D-U-M-B-R-A-T-E, adumbrate.
Dilapidated, dilapidated.
Dilapidated, D-I-L-A-P-I-D. A-T-E-D, dilapidated.
Correct. Cordillera, Cordillera.
Cordillera, C-O-R-D-I-L-L-E-R-A, Cordillera.
Okay. She is the correct alternate pronunciation of that word. Hyacinth.
Hyacinth. H Y A C I N T H. Hyacinth.
Tautology.
Tautology. T A U T O L O G Y. Tautology.
Correct. Machiavellian.
Machiavellian, M-A-C-H-I-E-V-E-L-L-I-A-N, Machiavellian.
I'm sorry, the correct spelling is M-A-C-H-I-A-V-E-L-L-I-A-N, Machiavellian. Your word is vacuousness.
Vacuousness, V-A-C-U-O-U-S, N-E-S-S, vacuousness.
This is our potential championship word. Loquacious.
Loquacious. L-O-Q-U-A-C-I-O-U-S. Loquacious.
We have a winner. Congratulations. So, Kyra, what school are you from?
Bradley Elementary.
Kyra Lucas from Bradley Elementary is our champion. Kyra Holland from Marshall is our first runner-up. And both of these fabulous spellers will advance to the Regional B, which will be held in Fredericksburg on March 21st. Congratulations to both of you. Banks here? Okay, Ms. Banks, would you like to come to the stage and Dr. Jack? And we'll present the trophy. Also, each of these spellers will win a dictionary, and I expect they have a good collection of them already.
Let's move closer so we can get out of the way of the microphone.